We will not use the typical art materials. I mean, yes and no. We will use markers. We will use, if you want to, pencils and eraser, just in case. However, I think markers will be just okay by itself, as well as the highlighters. As a base, we will use something else. We will not use the regular paper or a canvas. Instead, guys, we will be working on the plates, or styrofoam plates, or I don't know how you can call it, platters, and create the image inside of it. Why? Because, notice, those platters on those plates have already beautiful, beautiful rim here around. So when we will create the image inside of them, we will have nice frame. And all what we will need to do is to use masking tape, a little bit like a piece of the string, attach it to the back, and your parents will be able to hang this beautiful artwork once it's done on the wall, either yours or in, I don't know, in the dining room, to have fun, that you can all be proud of your creations. So let us start. First of all, we have to have an idea. So we already know we have the ground here. We will paint, we will draw inside here. We just have to decide for the composition. So that means we have to decide if this image will be placed vertically or horizontally. Notice that this is its horizontal position, composition. It's very often used in landscape because we have a field, elongated field, we have the elongated sky here, right? While this position, the vertical position, is excellent one when you want to work on portraits. So we have to make the decision what, first of all, on our subject matter. So if you want to do the landscape, and let us do one landscape, we will work in the horizontal position here. And I will right away go here in. So the most important is you have to decide if where will be the line dividing the sky from the land, right? So I would say, okay, this is our place where we'll play, where we will be drawing here, not on those parts of the styrofoam plate that are already going up, right? So this is the position. Make sure that those plates will be clean, right? Because wash them, ask your parents to help you with it, dry them up, and then they will be ready to go to work. So I'm creating the line here, and I can decide if the line will go very high or very low. Depends what is more important to me, right? If I want that, for example, the land is more important, I will create the line here. See here? This is my line here. And this line indicates that this is the land, this is the sky. Now, from there, I can simply go here with some clouds. Remember the trick that you have to use, according to make this picture coming towards us more, I want to create clouds that are a little bit bigger here, you see, on the top. I would even go a little bit over this. Oh, I like it, actually, the idea. You see here, like this. And then those clouds will become smaller, going closer to the line on the bottom here. So you see this cloud already is smaller. This cloud is a little smaller, right? And now maybe another one here will have lots of clouds. And then another cloud here really on the bottom here, right? Like you see how small it is? This creates nice depth of space. So that means we feel that this line is very, very far away from us and those clouds are coming closer to us. Okay, now since this line is placed so high, you see it's 1/3 here, 2/3 of the entire height of the paper or on the board here, styrofoam board. So we really feel the deep, deep space here. So now what I want to do, I want to create a small house here. You see, very small. I don't want to have a big house here. You can do the same, right? Then I want to have maybe a couple of bushes here, you see? And that will be like our prairie landscape, right? So you see maybe another one here, then we can have a couple of bushes here, right? Maybe another like tree here. You see, not really big ones, two trees, maybe another one here, right? Maybe another house somewhere here, right? Remember, oh, this is very tall, or maybe even a barn, right? Like this. Okay, so now what we want to do, we want to create a field here. And how we create the field? I will show you. I will think about making a point, like almost in thinking about the point being placed here, right? This is the point where I'm looking at my landscape. And now I can create some lines here coming like this, you see? Another one going to this point will go here. It's like approximate, you see? I will create the line here. This point will guide me, right? So you see from here, that's what I will have, right? The line, slightly under the angle. This line is coming here. I will create the line that is vertical, right away dropping from this point, you see here, like here. Notice I don't make heavy lines here. I don't make one heavy line. Now from here, I will make a line coming here. You see? And another, looking at this point, approximately, I will create another line coming here. Okay, and then looking at this point, another one somewhere here. So you see, I have my field. I have my beautiful field here going inside. So you see, those stripes become really skinny going towards the line, so-called horizon line. This point, it's called vanishing point. This is the point in which it's exactly there where we are standing and where we are looking. This is the position of our eyes when we are standing, right? And then all those lines more or less go towards this point. We didn't do it exactly like this, but that's okay. Now you can decide which colors we will be having here on the field. And since we think about Alberta, I think that we can place here a little bit of the yellow color. You see here? And I will use just, my highlighters here. See, not very strong. They don't come very strong on it, but still they are. Like you see, it's enough. Okay, and I will make another field here with the, I don't know, what could it be? What do you think? Canola? No, this is more of canola, right? This is more greener, so I don't know what it would be. You think maybe that will be with, that will be our canola. Okay, here. And I think every second stripe will represent a part of the field that represent a particular grain. See, here we have wheat and here we have canola. Okay, so maybe a little bit more here of it. Oh, you see, I missed it here. So I will just go here like this. Okay, then I will place more of the highlighters. Let's see, maybe this highlighter will work better here. See, oh yeah, this is a stronger one. You see, we'll come here, a little bit of it here. If you think that you want to have, let's see, that imagine now we are in Holland and you want to have filled with beautiful tulips. So we can then think about bringing some other colors here, right? So for example, let me see. I will apply a little bit of the pink here, right? So you see one of those fields, I just change it. You see, we can apply some of the pink here. If you want, we can also bring it here. So, right, you can play with the colors that you think will work nicely in your painting. Now, when we go to the sky, again, what we want to use those highlighters, right? So the sky, you can reverse it. You can make the clouds blue and leave the sky white, but I think it would be better when you just simply go with highlighter. Notice, not even the Sharpie. If you want to, you can, but I think highlighters work really well here, you see? So we can create a beautiful landscape painting using just one Sharpie, black Sharpie, and then the highlighter. So you see here, I have my nice landscape. If you want to, we can go here around. See, we can go around here. You don't need to, but you can, you see? And then here we have our painting. If you want to, you can come on the top now and decide if you want to have a certain color here. You can also apply it. You don't need to, right? You see here for the edge. That's what you can come here. Doesn't need to be done, but if you think that it will be better, you can do it. Right, and we will have our painting, except that I'm missing, you see, the color for the bushes and for the trees. So here I can simply go with the color, and the barn usually is red, so I don't have the right highlighter, so I will use the Sharpie and just apply a little bit more of it here. So you see, that will be my field. I can make those lines. You see, if I want, I can add some other colors here, and that will be my field. So have fun, you see here. You can go a little bit stronger here if you want to, right? And that will be our painting. Now, the one extra point here that I wanted to mention to you, if you want to, you can make those clouds, you can outline them with a blue Sharpie if you want to, right? So there will be another additional part, and you can make it a little bit, just one side. Don't make sure that you don't work on all the sides. Okay, so this is our lovely drawing done using markers, and now I want to show you what we can do here. So here I want to work on the flower. So I will make here, I will make a ground here, and I want to have a flower. So first, one flower, notice the head of the flower, it's going slightly under the angle, the direction. So I will have the petals a little bit wider and bigger coming here, and smaller, like you see, smaller going back here. One. Now I want to have another flower here, and this time I want to have a tulip. You see, one, you make another one here and another one here, right? Now I want to have another similar flower to this one here, just rounder. Okay, and then very much facing us. So I make the patterns very much on the same size. Don't press your Sharpie too much. You see, a little bit bigger here. Okay, so I have it. Now, what I want to do, I need the stamps. So I'm going here with one stamp. I'm creating another stamp here for this flower. And I do another stamp for my tulip here, right? Now I have to decide for the leaves. So the leaf, this one will be like this. This one, maybe I put another one leaf here and another one here. Okay, so from there, if you want to, you can place some grass here like this, right? And it's okay when it's black, don't worry about it. Okay, like this, like this, like this, right? Good. So now what we want to do, we want to make sure that we use the colors. So I will use yellow for this, for the outline, not for the outline, for the patterns here for this flower. See, the same way. Okay. I'm sure that you have lots of those styrofoam platters at home. Just ask your parents and they can save some of them, because that's what they do. They, when they buy some food, especially meat, it comes on those platters, right? But not just the meat, like sushi, sometimes buy on them as well. Okay, here we have grass, and we can have here our leaves. So you see the leaves will come here. Then I think that I want to use another of those highlighters here. You see different brands have, just the color looks differently, despite that it's like you see green, but it looks different, right? So here we are. And then what I want to have, I want to have, and I'm still looking which colors I have here. I have another highlighter here. No, I like to have brown color. So I will use this Sharpie here. See, look what you have here. See, a little bit stronger here. And then I want to make just the outline here with brown. And maybe the same here, because I really like this flower. And then I will place another color, and I will place this time pink. Oh, I have two pinks here. Actually, I have a third one here as well. So this is quite bright. Okay, here will be my other flower. You see, so I'm going on top of the petals here. Then what I will do, I will go to this beautiful flower, and maybe this one will be blue. Maybe, or should we put the sky blue? No, then we'll save it for something else. Okay, so I have to decide, maybe I place this pink color here. You see another one here. And then what I want to have, I want to have the sky. They still need to have a ground here. So I will go with some of the green. Don't press it too much. You see what has happened to me? I press it too much. I have indent dead there. Okay, here. You can see it. Voila. Now, what we need to have, if you want to have a sky, you can work on the sky. Now, I want to have a blue color here coming. And if you want to have, you can place nice clouds, and I would make them in blue. You see, so one cloud will come here. You can also extend it here. So you see, one cloud will come here, and another cloud maybe here. See, and another one will come here if you want to, right? So you see, clouds will be blue, or you can make the whole sky blue if you have a blue, lots of blue highlighters. See here, and then I place another one here. If you want to, you can also create the sun. See, here we are. Maybe another one cloud will come here as well. See, more. And then I just decided on the spur of the moment that I want to have extension of my ground, right? So you see, you can extend it even here and then place more of the grass here, you see? Oh wow, that's actually will look good like this, right? Then if you want to, you can go on top of your clouds and just outline them a little bit stronger, right? With the, if you have Sharpie, use the Sharpie here, see? Voila, and that will be our project, guys, you see? So we have, oh, no. Then if you have a green, we also have to extend it here. And this will be our project, you see? So we have already two of them, one and another one here. If you want, you can go on the top here, and with the Sharpie, you can make a nice outline, right? So that we have a frame here. Be careful, just that you don't cross the line. You don't need to do it again, it's up to you. I will just try it because I want to see how the image will look like with the frame marked in certain color, right? So I chose red because I think red will give me very nice contrast. Okay, here. And then it's a little bit more of it here. Right here. And there's still a little bit more on this side here. Then I will have my red frames. But like I said, you don't need to do it. That's optional. You can experiment with colors. And when you don't like certain color, you can certainly come always with the black on the top, right? That will be the solution if the choice of the color was not the best one, right? Let's see how we will decide about this one here. Actually, I don't mind it as red, you see? So it's quite bright. We have already two images. We have landscape, we have flowers. And I will just show you the last one. That will be the landscape, okay? Not landscape, cityscape. So again, we create the line here. And then you see, I have those parts here of the glue. So I just create the buildings here. Like this, like this, like this, like this, right? Like this, like this, and like this. Okay, so from there, let's see, that's the water here. So we'll have those buildings reflected in the reflection of those buildings in the water here. And another one coming here. And the one that coming here. Another one coming here, you see? Another one shorter, a little bit shorter. You see how I create the reflection? It's like a moving water, right? You see? A little bit longer. I'm just watching the length of the buildings, right? So when you have those buildings, you can also make them simply black. Just make them black, okay? Because that's the night, right? So we do them during the nighttime. Okay, like this. And another one here. Right, and another one here. So you see, I'm still adjusting to the glow that I was not able to take from the board. You see, we are artists and we always have to find solution to the problem. So this, someone will ask you, what is this? And you can just say something. You can find out. Oh, you said, oh, there was a special pattern on my, I wanted to have it on my building. Oh, I just liked it and that's why I kept the glue there, right? So you see another building, another one here. You can still extend this line here if you want to. You can see another building and then reflection here. Another building, maybe here small, and we'll have another reflection, right? Here I want to have a tree. So you see, then I will have reflection of the tree and so on. Another tree here, reflection. And then you can make here the same extension here. See, taller building. Maybe another one here, right? Like you see what I'm doing here. And then reflection going, shoo, 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 shoo. Now, from there, what we want to have? Maybe we want to have like a moon, dark moon here, or maybe sun, you decide. And then what you can do, clouds, you can have clouds if you decide that you want to have them. But I just wanted to show you here, you see, when we decide that this is lighter, then we'll make it lighter. And in the water, you can place, I have my I have my highlighter. So in the water, I can place a little bit of the color here, you see? And right away, I have beautiful beautiful cityscape with buildings reflecting, the shape of the buildings reflected in the water. So you see here I have it. And then maybe I just make a couple of, why not? I like to have a clouds here. So what I have to do, like you see, I would make them using the blue color. You see, just gently. Notice that I don't complete the lines. It's not one heavy line, it's a broken line. You see, that looks really nice like this for the clouds. You see, they are lighter. Okay, so you see, that will be my cityscape with reflection, maybe a little bit of the green here on the bottom. You see, if you want to, right? So you see, that's our next project. So we have three of them. I show you how to do the flowers, show you how to do the landscape and cityscape. So guys, have fun and see you next time. Bye.